Off they go. Jackie and the kids are off to visit her mother. So for the next 9 or 10 days, I'm going to be all alone. What to do? So I have this problem in the server room. This is our charging station. It's a complete mess and it only gets worse from here. As you're seeing it, the drone batteries aren't even there and it just seems like we have a ton of things to recharge and that list keeps getting longer. My wife wears wireless headphones as she does housework all the time. And they always need to recharge. I have these noise canceling things I wear when I do tractor stuff. It always needs charging. The drone batteries, we wear these things out like 3 times a week-ish, maybe. You can see I've got radios there for the power motor. I'm going to have GoPros. I need to do a better job of organizing my charging area.
One more thing. More.
Good. Not perfect, but way better than before. I'll take it. I don't know how I'm going to buy gas for my paramotor. I hope that this week I begin flying. It's ambitious, but possible. So, it doesn't, like, you can't use ethanol, and here in America, like, all the fuel has ethanol in it, and that's not okay. Also, it needs to be at least 95 octane, which you'd think is the kind of rating you just ignore, because cars are so smart about variable timing and stuff that you can kind of ignore it with them. But in a paramotor, you can't. So, I have to find gas that doesn't have ethanol that has at least 95 octane. Look at the state of this truck. It is dangerously low on gasoline, and the check engine light is on. The check engine light is something I aspire to fix tomorrow. There's a bad O2 sensor. The fact that I'm out of gas, I'll take care of that as soon as this woman in the snazzy clothes finishes fueling her car. Why not just use 93? I mean, it's really close to 95, and there's two issues with that. One, we are talking about the safety and reliability of a flying machine, so it's not the sort of thing that you take shortcuts with. And two, it has ethanol in it. And while I'm pretty much whatever the equivalent of illiterate is for chemistry, I do know that ethanol is a solvent, and that is the reason that it's not cool to put ethanol in the motor that I have. It will break down some membrane tube or whatever. So I need to get 95 or better octane without ethanol. Man, this looks like a total bust. And not only is it like not a great gas station, It's not even an average gas station. I'm gonna go inside and ask him if I'm like missing something. But I drove 20 minutes to get here. Ah. So the guy inside said he gets this a lot, but he couldn't help me. So I need another plan. So near that other place, I found this racetrack, and according to the internet, this racetrack is supposed to sell race fuel, like this 100 octane lead free, ethanol free stuff. So far, I don't see anything. I'll keep driving around. Race car. But it's not gas, so let's get back on mission. Hello?
Hello? Yes.
Do you sell high octane gas?
Right now is the Bloomin' Snucco, which is the
120 octane. I'm sorry, I couldn't make that out. How much octane?
It's 112 to 115.
Oh.
What the blue is.
Okay, that'll do. Right, what time do you close?
We close at 6.
6?
At 6 o'clock.
So you're closed now?
Yeah.
Oh. Okay, thank you for your help.
Alright.
Bye. I don't know. Ah, music. I'm not sure if I'd call that a win or a bust, but definitely calling ahead is the way to go going forward. A number 6, medium with sweet tea.
Anything else?
Nope. Thank you. My wife would be so disappointed if she knew that 12 hours after she left, I started eating Wendy's. But we still love you, Wendy's. Here I am. So I guess it's difficult to call that a success, but I'm home. I ate. It solved one of my problems, and I kind of solved a problem in that I found a place that sells it, even if they were closed and I didn't get it. So, step in the right direction. Let's fix the lighting. So, I keep seeing these vloggers who say that vlogging is ruining their lives. And in some cases, I kind of get where they're coming from. Like in the boyfriend-girlfriend vloggers, like what they were saying is it's difficult to live a life under a public eye. Now they've been doing it forever and their channels were, you know, bigger than mine's ever been. So I can kind of get on board with the fact that they're facing pressures that not everybody else faces. Like I get that and I have some empathy for it. I see a lot of other vloggers who say, oh my gosh, you know, I vlog every day or I vlog this often, like the pressure is relentless, it's never ending. You know, I want to go out golfing and I have to bring this camera with me. I want to go here and I have to do that. Don't have a lot of sympathy for that because I feel like maybe some of these guys are young and they're just learning what work is like. And they say, man, like work really gets in the way of my golfing game. Work really gets in the way of me playing video games. Like I want to do this or that, all these non-work things. And I find that vlogging interferes with it. Yeah, it does. I get that. It does. But dude, try getting a job. Try working like 40 hours and going to school at night. Try working 65 hours. Work will mess with everything. Like, that's what it takes. I hear people say, like, you know, I couldn't fully enjoy, you know, the day at the go-kart races. I made that one up. Because, you know, I had to bring my camera with me. And I think, man, you know, there's someone out there with busted up knuckles, you're working underneath a car, thinking, oh, was your day ruined at go-kart racing because you brought a camera? Right, there's some nurse out there changing bedpans thinking, man, it must be rough on you to bring your camera while you're eating at a restaurant. And I feel like that too. I think that sometimes these guys who haven't spent decades doing real work don't know how lucky they are that this is their gig. You know, is gaming and making commentary videos tough? you won't like the alternatives, you know? And some of these guys are so well paid, it's like, dude, like, you're making six digits or better at this. You're successful. Be so happy with what you have, because someday you're going to look back and be like, man, you know, can you believe I spent 10 grand? Like, it didn't have much value. Then you'll realize just how hard it is to set aside like 10,000, 15,000, whatever, when you work like everybody else does. So, I feel the rain of, you know, my saving advice coming back at me right now, but just the same. Does vlogging ruin your life? I feel for you on the feedback. I don't feel for you on the workload. Everybody has a hard workload, a heavy workload, and you know, YouTube's just like any other job. Multi-million-dollar deals, got a million-dollar deal. When I was younger, I would wonder how $1 million feel. And for real,